Welcome back to another episode of Tuesday's Tips. I'm Jeremy Bailey, your Flying Realtor. Today is week 9 in our 10-week mini-series for the top 10 tips when it comes to selling your home or buying your home. Let's jump on over to the studio where Suzanne Caldera from Guaranteed Rate is there with us. All right, thank you, Suzanne, for coming back on another episode of Tuesday's Tips. I can't believe we're nearing the end of our 10-week series. We're on week 9. My seller tip for today is consider hiring a professional cleaner. With very few exceptions, many of you have a very clean home, but it's not professional clean. There's something to be said about that. You wanted to really focus on the kitchens and baths, because that's what people are really looking. The kitchens and baths are what really sell the home. So even if you hire a professional cleaner to do a few rooms, kitchens and the baths, but hire a professional cleaner, it's worth the few hundred bucks that you spend depending on the size of your house. And for the buyers, I'm going to toss it over to you, Suzanne. What do you have for us for the buyers?
This is an advice tip that when you get a home, you'd be miles ahead of the average homeowner if you can bank anywhere from $2,000 to $4,000 a year for the oh crap stuff. There are things that are going to happen a year, 2, 3 years down the line. And that's sometimes how I see people taking on additional debt with the Home Depot charges and Lowe's and all that other stuff. So if you can just build up that house account when your water heater goes or, I don't know, something breaks, you've got that account. The other part two of that tip is many realtors are advising their clients to not do a home inspection or to do one for informational purposes only. Now, some realtors may not like this that I'm putting this out there, but if you don't have a good fund in the bank or funds that you can lean on if something goes wrong, you may not be the best candidate for that. Because a few months later or 6 months later, what is that plan? Now, if you have a definitive plan and you say, okay, I've got X and X, or I've got my uncle or my father who's a contractor and I know that I'm going to be okay, all right, then you're fine. But if you don't know the first thing about fixing something or you don't really have much in the bank, you're setting yourself up for failure. So just be really cautious with that. And that's the buyer's tips for this week for me, Jeremy.
I love it. That's great advice. You know, as you mentioned, I advise many of my clients that in order to get our offer to be even considered, even if we're on point with the price point, it's we need to waive inspections. But most of the time that happens in my second or third time home buyer clients, with very few exceptions that you mentioned, maybe dad's a contractor and wants to come in and take a peek. I don't generally recommend that my first time home buyers waive inspections because, like you said, most of the time, with some exceptions, there's not a whole lot of cash reserves. They've never owned a home before, so they don't understand that. Oh yeah, when the water heater blows, you know, I'm on the hook for $1,500 and I need to have it right now, or I'm putting it on a credit card if they take credit cards and I'm ringing up debt. So for first time home buyers, you know, that's something that's just excellent advice. I just can't, you know, I just want to reaffirm what you said. Have a little extra, have that little nest egg set aside. That's not my go to Jamaica fund. You know, that's, it sits there, it's fixed, it's untouchable, and or think of it as untouchable until you need it. And eventually you will need it. You will. That's part of homeownership. You do have to do updates and repairs and things like that. But, you know, there are many benefits to it as well.
Thanks.
All right. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Tuesday's Tips. I'm Jeremy Bailey, your Flying Realtor. Remember to keep your wings level, and I gotta fly.